you don't anticipate, you never know, I mean, with the backup, how they're going to perform in a game. You can only go off what you see in practice. And a lot of that is based on, you know, spring ball two-a-days. Because when you get into a game week, it's not like you're doing a lot of competing for a job that week. You're getting, you know, you're putting in a game plan. You're focusing on that is not so much as, is this guy beating this guy out, unless they're very close. But you're going to look at them as being very close, how they came out of fall camp. You know, so that's so important, you know. And then to see these guys step up and make plays, you know, when they've had their opportunity, you know, unless you've ever been in that situation and you've been a backup, you don't understand how hard that is to prepare yourself each and every day that you're one play away, or you may never touch the field. You know what I'm saying? So you're preparing yourself and you may not touch the field, and you prepare yourself and you may not touch the field, and you prepare yourself and then all of a sudden you're on the field. You know, and so it takes a very a tough-minded kid to be able to handle that situation.
Is there anybody that really kind of surprised you this year? You say they really struggled through spring camp, and here they are, you know, making an impact.
I'll tell you, I'll be probably Martez most impressed with what he's done, you know, because didn't know how he was going to handle the situation, and he didn't have a choice, you know, and it wasn't, you know, get him a few reps here, get him a few reps there. Now, he was a standout for us on special teams all the season, you know, but wasn't sure how he was going to handle it when he had to carry the load, and he's done a great job with that.
Eddie Willing made that decision whether or not he plays in this, and you may make that decision next week?
We'll make that decision next week.
Look back over the three games. Defense has been pretty dominating. Is there anything that stood out, or is it just, like you keep saying, buying into what y'all teach?
I think a lot of it has to do is they, you know, and you know, I know no one would believe me when I said they're getting a little bit better each week. It you know, one week it was this guy, one week it was this guy, you know, and I think now, I mean, our defensive line as a unit played the best they've played all year. And I've continued to say that they're getting a little bit better. They're getting a little bit better. You know, the linebackers have been solid all year, but they played well. You know, the secondary has been, you know, there were times where we didn't think, you know, maybe this guy wasn't getting better, but this guy was. Well, they played a great game the other night. I mean, just a play here, a play there, a couple calls, you know, and they played an excellent game. I mean, so I just think it's a accumulation of, you know, they've continued to work hard. They've learned from the experiences they've gotten through earlier in the season. And when those things have come up now later in the season, they've taken advantage of it. Oh, there's no doubt, you know, because, I mean, there were a lot of people that were on them pretty hard. I mean, saying, you know, trying to put that they were the reason that we weren't being successful, and that was not the case, you know. And so, I mean, to see them just to stay focused, keep believing in what the defensive coaches are telling them and keep doing it, I mean, that is rewarding.
Is Coach Bradford ever allowed to coach
on
the field again?
Oh, yeah, Todd and I talked about it the other night because we've had numerous people say, well, you've played well three games and you've been in the box three games, you know. And sure, I'm sure that has something to do with it because he can see more from up there. It's you're in a controlled atmosphere. You don't get so emotional when you're on the field, you know. Plus, I've tried to stay off the phones as much as possible when the defense is on the field. You know, they don't need my 2 cents worth, you know, as much. And just let them do what they do. And I think, you know, again, they have done a great job. I mean, if you look at what the defense has done, I mean, it has been dominant the last 3 weeks. I mean, one drive against UCF, you know, and other than that, they have been dominant.
Coach Fair, in this whole season, what kind of impact has he had on the team?
Man, I mean, just he has to be an inspiration to every one of our players and everybody on our staff. I mean, you know, nobody in here has ever experienced that, I hope, you know, what Barney's going through. We're fortunate that we have an alum, Bobby Dews, who's been there to, right there along with him, has gone through the exact same thing. Pat Sullivan, has been there to, you know, on the phone with him, you know, weekly. Bobby's on the phone with him daily, you know, and no one, you know, we don't know what Barney's going through. We, you know, because we haven't experienced it, we can, you know, one thing we have done is we have not ever tiptoed around the subject with our players or with Barney. You know, I mean, we decided we're gonna hit this thing head on and we're gonna fight it, all of us, you know, and give him all the support. Not pity. We've never pitied him because that's not the way that man is. You know, he doesn't want pity. That guy is a fighter, you know, and there were times that I had to challenge him, you know, because he was down and he was tired and I could see it, and I would challenge him. You know, and I don't know. There's some people you couldn't do that with. Barney, he needed that. That's what gets him out of bed every morning, is that challenge and that fight. And you know, and I mean, what he's gone through this season, what he's done, and what he's meant to this football team. You know, it's unbelievable.
Have you ever had to tell him to slow down a little bit? I mean, he's out there
constantly. Yeah, constantly. Go home, get some rest. You know. And I mean, he takes that as a challenge, you know, so he doesn't do it, you know, and I worry about him constantly, you know, but he, I mean, you know, ask somebody like Bobby Dews what Barney's doing. I mean, a guy that's been through it, experienced it, know how he feels each day, you know. I mean, I can only tell you what I see. Bobby's been through it. He knows what Barney's doing, and it's amazing. Yes, I mean, totally. He's not coaching at all. I mean, he's not coaching. He's not involved in that part of it. You know, he's gone quite a bit, so he's not involved in the game planning. I mean, you know, when he's over there, his treatments and everything, he's gone a lot of the day. But what he does is he gets out there on the field, and the kids see him every day, and they see his attitude when he's out there on the field. I mean, he's always so upbeat and positive with the players, you know, and just them knowing what he's going through. And to be that positive and upbeat, that's an inspiration in itself. We're pretty much the same way we were going into this game, so we didn't come up with any new injuries. You know, more bumps and bruises. I mean, obviously, after a very physical football game, you know, we knew it was going to be a physical game. We said going into the game, the most physical team was going to win, and we felt like we were the most physical team the other night. You know, but Damian, I mean, he's sore, obviously. I mean, he rushed for 120-something yards on a leg that was probably about 80%, you know, and he's a tough kid, you know, and he willed himself to do all those things. Torrey's, you know, better. I mean, he's still not 100%, but he's better. So the rest that he's gotten has been good for him. So those guys will continue to rehab them all week and hopefully have them back at 100% next week. Chico's won't be with us. I mean, he's done for the year. I mean, that from what I understand, that bucket tear, you know, in his in the knee. I mean, when they go back in and stitch that thing, I mean, it puts him out for a while. So now I don't know after the season's over, after the regular season, I don't know what it means, but we'll have to find out.